Hi, Ross here from Search and Filter. Today I'm going to show you how to use Elementor with Search and Filter version 3. Let's get stuck in. So we're starting with a relatively bare bones website. We have the latest version of Elementor and Elementor Pro. We have the Search and Filter and Search and Filter Pro beta. We also have WooCommerce installed and then the Search and Filter Elementor extension, which you can get from your account on our website. So make sure you download that, make sure it's version 1.3 and install that. And I think for this demo, we'll create a filter for the post widget and a filter for the products widget. So let's start by creating a page. And we'll add a two-column layout. And on the right side, we'll add the products widget. One thing to note is this source dropdown is where we'll be selecting our integration with Search and Filter, the Search and Filter query. We'll be coming back to that later. And in the left column, we'll add some fields. That would be the Search and Filter field widget, but we don't have any fields created yet. So we're going to go back into the admin area and create those. So we head to the Search and Filter admin menu. The first thing we're going to do is create a query that's going to connect with the products query. It's a Search and Filter integration query. What we'll want to do is set that to single post because we're viewing it on an individual page. We'll auto detect the page. And from the query dropdown, we have a few Elementor options to choose from. So because we're using products, we'll choose the Elementor WooCommerce products query. I'll see the post type has been auto set to products. There's quite a few other options here that we're not going to get into today. I'll also make sure dynamic update is enabled. And we'll just go with the defaults for that. So now the query has been created, we can add some fields to that query. So let's create a search field. And update the label. And we'll leave the rest as it is. That's good to go for the search field. We'll save that. Then we can head back to the query. We'll see the search field is connected with the products query. We can create another field. And this time we will use some WooCommerce specific options. So I've selected WooCommerce from the data type. And then from the data source, we have the various WooCommerce attributes, stock status, on sale, tags and categories. So I'm going to choose color. And then we'll leave the rest as it is. Let's go back to the query. Let's add an attribute. And we'll choose WooCommerce data type again. Let's go with categories actually. And we'll save that and head back to the query. So now you can see we have a search field, a color filter field, a product categories field. And I think I'm going to add just a reset button. That's a control type field. We'll change the control type to reset and the label and save that. So now we have a query with several fields connected to it. And the query is connected to our Elementor WooCommerce products widget. So now what we have to do is head back to the Elementor page. I'll reload this. So the first thing we'll do is we'll connect this products widget to the search and filter query. You can see here's the products query. That's all we have to do there. That means they're connected now. So now we'll head to our field and we can choose one of the fields that we've just created. So we'll start with a search field and then we can add another field after. And then we can add another one after that. And finally the reset. So that should be all you need to get going. Let's see if that's working. Yeah, and there we go. So there's just a couple of things that I would change. Is in the query settings, I would enable the indexer so we can have dynamic fields. Just a quick thing that I'll show you with the fields is we can change the design of the fields in the field editor using the styles tab. So we could quite easily make this like a dark mode input field. There we go. So let's do the exact same thing for the posts. Actually, we'll use the loop grid to build out this page. So we'll pre-make our elements this time. We'll do it in reverse order. So we'll start with a query. We know that's going to be in a single post. Auto detect. And then we'll choose from the dropdown Elementor loop grid. And the query this time, we'll use the posts, post type. And so that's the query setup. And then we'll add some fields to the query. We'll make this a autocomplete field and we'll connect that to the categories taxonomy. And then we'll add maybe something for tags. Maybe this time we can use checkbox. And then we'll add a reset button. That's a control type field. Change the control type to reset. So there we go. We have three fields connected to our loop grid, which we defined here. And now we'll create a page to facilitate that. Again, we'll just do a two-column layout. Add a loop grid. And a featured image. And that will do for this one. And then the same as with the products widget, we need to set the query to search and filter query. Here we choose the loop grid. We can put a message in for when nothing's found. And then on the left, same as before, we'll add our fields. I'm actually just going to add a few fields at the same time. I think we have another one. Let's get rid of that. So now we've got all these added. We should see that everything is working. And again, we don't have the indexer on, so we're going to get some situations where there are no results. So we'll go back to the grid, to the loop grid query, enable the indexer. Usually have to wait a few moments. And there we go. Now we have the dynamic fields too. So that's it. We've seen very quickly how to use Search and Filter version 3 with Elementor. We've created two examples, one using the products widget and one using the loop grid widget. I'd love to get your feedback. If you come across any issues, you can leave a comment below or get in touch via the usual channels. Thanks for watching.